Okay, this is how you attempt to put together the retro projector from Wyze. And it is kind of messed up, so go with me. First of all, it tells you all the ingredients that they have inside of the kit, but they forgot to put this in their description. It's actually double-sided tape, which it never says anywhere, but it's double-sided. So you have to take off each of the little tiny brown strips that look like this and remove them carefully. And then the tape is on the other side of that and is very difficult to get off. But you'll see that here in a second. So the first thing that's confusing is that they show this picture diagram here with the folds on the wrong side. Wrong side meaning they're really on this side. So now it doesn't look like that picture. It looks like the mirror image of that picture. So assuming that's incorrect, I'm going to go with that because you can't see where the folds are if you have it like this. The next thing is it says pop out cardboard, which I've done. That's step one. Step two, click lens, stick lens to opening flat side down. Well, that really makes a big difference whether this is the opening side down or if this is the side down. So I'm going to, like I say, I'm going to go with the incorrect way because it makes more sense to me. There definitely is a flat side of this lens and a rough side. The rough side has the little grooves on it. So if that's the flat side down, it will go like this. And down, as they show, it's like this. So it's not down, it's out or in or some other word, but it's not down. But anyway, if it was down, you would lay it down on the table, maybe like this, with the folds coming in, not backwards. And then you've got the mastery problem of getting this piece of tape off around that little thin thing and I guess putting it on top of that tape, which I'm going to try second. I'm actually going to go to the next step, which is step number three, to close the inner housing so I can learn how to do it. So here's my housing. I have folded it inwards. Then it doesn't tell you, but this could be either folded on the outside or on the inside. And I'm going to choose the outside because it just makes more sense to hold it. Then, as you can see, I've cheated, I've started this double-sided tape thing right here, and that's the double-sided tape that's kind of foggy in color, and I'm going to put it on the inside because against it's double-sided and therefore it sticks to itself. I'm going to put it on the inside of that little flap. And it's not perfect, but I don't think it's gonna matter. And you put that piece there and then tape it. So now that's stuck. So if that's the way you do it, you must have to do the same thing with this side. And now you're gonna see how hard this is. The top part comes off pretty easy, meaning, oh geez. Well, I'm gonna take the top part off all the way around like this. Don't let it stick to itself because it's really sticky. And then I'm gonna put the tape around this circle. And I've got one side of the double-sided tape still covered with the sealant, with the like paper, it's like wax paper. So I'm going to put this on like so, and then run it all the way around. I hope this is the way you do it. There, I've got a little bump in it, but again, that probably won't matter. Now I'm going to take off the wax paper, which is a matter of somehow peeling that off. Now you can see here on the double-sided tape, and I'm going to put the smooth side down, like it says, but I'm putting it on down on the back side of this. And I think I'm just going to do it so that it's centered as best I can. Then go to the next step, which is to fold this inwards and make, again, one of these little multi-sided things. And then this is gonna go down and then those are gonna go in. So I guess you fold all those in like so. And then when I get to the other side, I'm going to try to get that double-sided tape on there. So it's going to go on that surface right there. They do have a bigger one and a smaller one, so I'm going to do the smaller one now because this tab is smaller than the other tab. And I'm going to put it on the inside of it. Like so, and then I'm going to take off the wax paper and recycle that. Now I'm going to shape this again and tape it to itself. And I guess you could reinforce this with real tape, but they tried to provide the tape for you. Okay, the next step is to take the two pieces you have and slide them into each other, and they actually do fit very snugly. And when you push it in, it doesn't go all the way down because of the flaps that are on the inside. But that's okay because the slots that are on the sides of this, there's one giant slot, then there's two small slots. Those come flush with the, I'll call it the cap. And as I have it now, the smooth side is on the outside, the rough side of the lens is on the inside, and this inner part goes into it. Now it's just a matter of putting these slides, they call them films, film one, film two, and film three, into this slot. It actually fits quite nicely and then goes down into that lower slot, mostly to line it up and to center it. So I haven't turned on the light to see how this works yet, so I don't know if this should be faced inwards or outwards, but I'll figure that out when I turn on the light and put this on it. That will be the next step. So then it looks like there are three of these, one, two, three, and they have different things on them, different emojis is what they look like, and words. Anyway, the one I started with says, it just says love, hashtag love. Anyway, I will show you that in a second. The next step I'm using is to take this projector device and put it on the lamp. It fits on quite snugly, which is nice. And I don't think it matters how far it is pushed on. But what does matter a lot is the distance between the lens and the film. So you can push this out and get it to focus. As you can see, I'm just facing it on a wall that's about 10 inches away, maybe a quarter of a meter. Anyway, and I can see that it's focused on the top or bottom, not perfectly, but that has more to do with the tilt of this outer box. This thing swivels around a little bit. And I did it up on the ceiling. It's daytime right now. I did it up on the ceiling, and it shows on the ceiling and has to be focused again. But I don't have that in dark, total darkness, which would certainly come out better. Anyway, you get the idea. And it's kind of fun if you're really young, which it says you're not supposed to use it for young people. Anyway, that's it.